Our second metric we will be calculating is the MACD. This is a momentum indicator created through three exponential moving averages, often subtracting a fast moving average from a slower moving average to get your MACD, and then using what's called a signal line as a 9-period exponential moving average as that signal. As these two cross, they're often used to determine enter and exit conditions of trades. So not only do they show momentum, they're also good for utilizing, you know, those entry and exit points in conjunction with our other metrics, as we've talked about, or other metrics of your choice. The steps that we're going to follow to calculate this is, of course, similar to our last example, downloading our historical data from YFinance. We are going to create another function, this time to calculate our MACD and our signal values. We are then going to return these values in one call to our created data frame, and we will create two new columns with the same call to append our MACD and our signal. Again, as in our last value, I want to throw credit to Rune at learnpythonwithrune.org, another great resource that I'd recommend to do a little more deep dive into the MACD calculation. So let's go ahead and jump to our live example.